So this is the general identified characteristics of D and F block elements. Let us have a side heading as D block elements. What is D block elements separately? So as we mentioned just now, the D block elements are also called as transition metals. They are called as transition metals. So let us have why they are called as transition metals. The most important case here, the characteristics of D block elements present in between electropositive S block and electronegative P block elements. That means the properties of D block elements transitions takes place between S block to P block. Hence they are called as transition metals. So as I explained just now, all the elements belongs to D block and F block are metals. So hence they are called as metals, transition metals. Why they are called as transition metals or transition elements? The characteristics of D block elements are transferred or transition takes place between S block to P block. Hence it is called as transition metals. And next one, all the elements belongs to D block with metallic character. As I just mentioned here, metallic character. So what are metallic character? The geometry are, they are with ductility and they are with malleability and they used as, they are with metal lustre and they used as thermal and electricity conductors. So all these are metallic characters. Such metallic characters are exhibited by D block elements. Now let us have electron configuration. The most important phenomenon in case of D block elements is electron configuration. We have to know the general electron configuration first. This general electron configuration we can apply to all the elements. So let us have, what is the general electron configuration? N minus 1 D 1 to 10 NS 1 to 2. So this is the general identified electron configuration of D block elements. Here the D block or D orbital, penultimate D orbital when valency S orbital present. What is valency S orbital? The valency orbit means the last orbit present in an orbit. So in an atom, here what is penultimate D orbital? Before last. So before the last orbital is called as penultimate orbital. So penultimate D orbital with valency S orbital completely included or completely gives us electron configuration for D block elements. So let us have scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc. So what are these? The 10 elements, these two 10 elements belongs to 3D series. These are 3D series elements, D block elements. Here, the general electron configuration or electron configuration for scandium will be 3D1, 4S2. Similarly, for this 3D2, 4S2. And similarly, for this 3D3, 4S2. Chromium 3D5, 4S1. The special case in case of chromium and copper, I will explain after general discussion with electron configuration. So, manganese 3D5, 4S2. Iron 3D6, 4S2. Cobalt 3D7, 4S2. Nickel 3D8, 4S2. Copper 3D10, 4S1. Zinc 3D10, 4S2. So these are the elements belongs to 3D series and their electron valency shell electron configuration. Just identify here, valency orbit is the fourth orbit and penultimate orbit is the third orbit. In this orbit, d orbital present with 1, 2, 3 up to 10 electrons starts with scandium to zinc. So the special category in case of chromium and copper electron configuration, this may be expected as important 2 months question. Electron configuration of chromium and copper. So let us write. Before going to write electron configuration of chromium and copper, we have to know off-filled orbitals or completely filled orbitals will give additional stability to atom.